Matt, I'd like you to do me a little favor today, and how about we look out the audience and a big round of applause for all the support you have. On behalf of the student athletes here, I know they appreciate the years of driving them to practices and all those games and all the travel ball and all that good stuff, and a result of that is we're here today. Also, how about everybody give a round of applause to our coaches up here on stage. Without further ado, you don't need to listen to me anymore. We're going to get handed over to coaches and recognize all these outstanding student athletes. But before we do that, we have Meredith Teal not here today. She is going to be signing with George Fox University, and she will be playing lacrosse in the fall. So, round of applause for Meredith. And we also have Zane Freak up here. He is going to Fairfield University to play lacrosse, and his coach is not here today. So we're going to have Zane go ahead and sign. Well, not sign yet, but we're going to recognize Zane as his coach isn't here. Round of applause for Zane.
As an assistant varsity coach for cross country and track, I'm speaking for my husband, Coach Greg Marm, who couldn't be here at lunch today. He's taking care of our puppy who has chemotherapy, so he apologizes. First, we have Dania Holmberg, who is an outstanding cross-country and track athlete. She will be attending Seattle Pacific on her letter of intent, and as well as academics. Dania Holmberg placed third in the state meet in cross-country this fall, and she is a huge point getter for us in track and field. Dania Holmberg. Kingler Elliott is one of our standout track and field athletes. She's been a varsity athlete with us since her freshman year. We were really lucky when she moved here from Arizona and continued with her track career here. She is a triple jumper and a high jumper for the Eagle Mustangs, and she will be attending Portland State with her scholarship for academics and athletics. Taylor Elliott.
We could go on and on for hours about the accolades that these four have combined. Number one in the nation, all conference, all state, all American. You can't even begin, because every day they make me smile. They're a blast to be around. So first thing, Rachel Menlove, she's our catcher. She'll be going to Portland State. She would be right here if she's gone today. Then we have Kelly Kukla, UC Colorado Springs. And then Hailey Fisher, Weber State. And Autumn Moffat, BYU. I'm excited for everything that they have accomplished as a high school athlete, and expect great things from them in the future.
Before I talk about these six, I want to acknowledge Zane down there, who would be making seven if you wanted to do that. Congratulations to Zane. I have offensive lineman Alec Kuzmack who will be attending Washington State University. Maxim Moore, offensive lineman, he'll be attending the University of Idaho. Kelvin, he's a defensive safety, and he'll be going to Rocky Mountain College. Todd Durham is an outside linebacker. He'll also be attending Rocky Mountain College. Ryan Swanson, we got here. He's a defensive back, and he'll be going to Portland State University. And I'm really proud of Caden Stooks, new to football, and this is where his hard work has taken him. He'll be going to Weber State as a tight end.
My name is Tony Hildy. I want to thank these two boys. They've made my transition into the new head baseball coach easy because of their leadership and what they've done. They're two kids that are going to have great seasons. They haven't had the opportunity to play this year, but they're two of the best in our state. And they both will be attending Spokane Falls to play baseball. So Reed Harrington and Christian Padilla.
coordinator, and I have the honor and privilege to introduce Miss Emma Bailey. Emma Bailey is going to be signing with BYU this year. It's been an honor to have her as a four-year starter, as coming in as a freshman and being such an integral part of the team. She's had a couple hard years with some injuries, but her tenacity and her strength and her power to overcome it and go on is such a great inspiration. So I'm so proud of her, and I'm looking forward to her future.
So it is National Letter Signing Day, so we should probably do some signing here. So at this time, let's grab a pen, and student-athletes go ahead and put a little pen to paper. Cameras are ready, and go for it. Now that you've all signed, go ahead and proudly hold up those certificates.
Woo!
I'd like to take some pictures.
Signing Day. One more time, congratulations to all the student athletes out here.